Hello and welcome to Let's Learn Grammar. Today we'll be discussing very briefly about clauses. You know that a sentence is a group of words that is complete in itself. They contain a subject and a predicate. When you look at the different components of a sentence, you can find that phrase and clause become part of a sentence. Let's move on to what clauses are. A clause is a part of a sentence that has a subject and a predicate. Now look at this sentence. If it rains, the match will be cancelled. We can see two clauses here. The first part, if it rains, and the second part, the match will be cancelled. The first part, if it rains, does not have an independent meaning. It cannot stand on its own. Such a clause, that's a part of a sentence which cannot stand on its own, is called as a dependent clause. The second part, the match will be cancelled, contains the main thought of the sentence and can exist on its own. We can therefore call it as the main clause or the independent clause. Look at the given examples here. In the first sentence, you will need a password if you subscribe to this online service. The part, if you subscribe to this online service, cannot stand on its own, and therefore it's the subordinate clause or the dependent clause, whereas the first part, you will need a password, can stand on its own, and therefore it's an independent clause. The second sentence, I look for careful attention to detail when I read a novel. The second part, when I read a novel, is the subordinate clause, and the first part, I look for careful attention to detail, stands on it on its own, and therefore it's the independent clause. Likewise, the third sentence, the store ran out of the sale item quickly because supplies were limited. The second part, because supplies were limited, is the dependent clause, whereas the first part of the sentence, the store ran out of the sale item quickly, is the main clause or the independent clause. Now this is how we can represent clauses. Here you can find that dependent or subordinate clause can be further divided into noun clause, adjective or relative clause, and an adverb clause. So remember, these are the separate categorizations of dependent or subordinate clauses. You have the noun clause, the adjective or the relative clause, and the adverb clause. Now we can move on to the first category, namely noun clause. In this case, the subordinate clause performs the function of the noun. It contains a subject and a predicate and carries out the work of a noun. Look at the sentence. I expect that I shall get a prize. The part, that I shall get a prize, contains subject and a predicate. It is the object of the verb in the sentence, that is expect. Therefore, it is a noun clause. Look at the given examples. Can you tell me the noun clause in the first sentence? Yes, it's right. The noun clause here is that I shall fail. Now what about the second sentence? Hope you have found out the answers. The third category of subordinate clause consists of adverb clauses. It does the work of an adverb and it modifies a verb, an adjective, or an adverb in the main clause. For example, the sentence, he ran like his life depended on it. Now, how did he run? You know, like his life depended on it. So obviously, the adverb clauses, like his life depended on it. Now the sentence, they rested when evening came. What tells us more about the verb rested? The part of the sentence when evening came. Hence, it is the adverb clause. Can you find out the adverb clause in these sentences? The first sentence, you may sit wherever you like. Yes, you're right. Wherever you like forms the adverb clause in the first sentence. What about the second sentence? You may act as you like. The answer is, as you guessed, as you like. It tells us the way in which you may act. Now, adverb clauses can be further divided again. First, we have the adverb clause of time. Here, time is highlighted. As in the sentence, a crow attacked your cat while I was waiting for the bus. When did the crow attack the cat? You know the answer, while I was waiting for the bus. So that part forms the adverb clause of time. The second division is adverb clause of place. Look at this sentence. Put the sign where the students can read it. Where the students can read it tells us about the place, and that forms the adverb clause of place. The next division we have is the adverb clause of manner. As in the sentence, she's acting as if she has stolen something. The way in which she is acting is further elaborated. The manner is elaborated, and that forms the adverb clause of manner. We have adverbs of condition, which tells us about some condition, as in the given example, if I have the time, I will show you the apartment. And as students of second semester, I would tell you that you need to pay attention to this adverb clause of condition, as it is likely to be asked for your examination. Now, moving on to the next, you have the adverb clause of reason. As in the sentence, he is absent because he is ill. Going ahead with further divisions, you have the adverb clause of result. As in the sentence, speak a little louder so that everyone can hear. The result is specified so that everyone can hear, making it the adverb clause of result. Again, you have the next one, adverb clause of degree. As in the sentence, Ankita can sing better than her sister. So there is a degree of comparison coming over there. Ankita can sing. How can she sing? Better than her sister, making it an adverb clause of degree. Now, these are the categorizations of clauses. As we discussed earlier, you have the noun clause, you have the adjective clause or the relative clause, and then you have the adverb clause. Now, let's see if you are capable of supplying suitable adverb clauses in these sentences. The first sentence, he spoke so low. I hope you can find an answer to this. Second one, he will succeed. There is a condition being specified. He always comes. It's the time being specified. He is so busy. And the last one, the boy went to play. I hope you could find suitable adverb clauses, answers to these questions. Good luck for your examinations.